Hey there, I'm Ali, and today we're diving into something really exciting. The kind of exciting that when you finish it, you'll be like,
sometimes my genius is... it's almost frightening.
You've probably seen the Typeform ads. Super sleek, easy to use, great reporting system. Until you see the...
price.
24 euros per month? Seriously? Well, since we are some kind of genius over here, we can do this for free. We can build this Typeform in just 20 minutes, free of charge, and with a lot more customizability and a lot more control. I want to keep this simple yet useful, a Typeform clone. Perfect for beginners and anyone curious about the app development industry. So let's get started. Over here, we're going to use Flutter Flow and Firebase, which are like the golden combination for app creation and idea development. Okay, now we're gonna create a new project, name it YouTube Typeform Clone. And for now, we're gonna skip setting up Firebase, and we'll do it later. So, we are greeted with the first page. We're going to change the name to welcome page and also create a new page, questions page, and delete app bar, and we can start designing the pages. You see what I did? I created the welcome page on the questions page. So if I just swap the names, it'll be good. On the first question, usually we ask the email, so let's do that. Now that the user has a way to enter the email, we need a way to let them go to the next page, so we're going to add a new button. Now that we have our next button ready, we can proceed to add some animations. No need to panic. Animations on Flutter Flow are super easy. we just go to the tab with the play icon at the top and add our animations. We can test which animation looks better. We can preview them on the builder. Okay, now that we have the animation that we like, we can just copy this one and paste it to any other widget we want. Now that we are finished with this question, we can just copy the column at the top and paste it to the next page view page. This way we will save all the styling and animations. For this question, we can change the answer input so the user inputs their answer with a radio button. Now let's just add the same animation into the radio button and change the question to like which package you are interested in or anything, and add a few options to the radio button. Done. And we can just again copy and paste the column into the next question and change the question and the possible answers. Now that we have our questions ready, you can add or remove any of the questions, obviously. And we can add a finish the state page to say thank you for your time, something like that. To make things a bit more fancy, we can just throw an icon, a crown icon actually, to make it seem nicer. Now that the UI section is finished, we just need to make some quick changes. We have to head on to the settings and on app details, change the entry page to welcome page. And now we can publish this version without the backend. To connect our project to Firebase, we can just head to the Firebase page and connect it to a Firebase project. Flutterflow does it all by itself. We just have to sign in with our Google account and it will create a project for this app. We are going to keep the database structure pretty simple and we're just gonna create a collection called Answers. And each time when the user answers the form that we have, we create a new document in the answers collection. So we have to save their email and the channel and the package and also when they answered it, so the created time. Our database is ready. Now we just need to tell Flutterflow what should happen after the user clicks on next. It should show the next question. And on the last question, we need to do an extra action, which is to create the answers field in the collection. And we should map the fields to the correct widget state. So map email to the text field and package to the first radio button and channel to the second radio button. And also save the current time as the created time. We are almost there. As the last step, we need to go to Firestore settings and edit the rules so that everyone can create an answer, but nobody can read, write, or delete them. And then hit deploy. We We have a small error over here, and to fix it, we just click on it, and then on this page, we hit on generate config files, and Flutterflow will take care of it. Now we can deploy our final product and test it real quick.
2 very boring minutes later.
I'm tired. Why aren't you working? If you enjoyed watching this video, please consider subscribing and hitting that like button.
A few minutes later.
Start. Oh yeah, we have it.
A great success!
And just like that, we have our very own beautiful online typeform clone. Obviously, it is super MVP, like pre-MVP. If you wanna see more features added into this clone, just let me know on the comment section. And see you in the next one.